So you might recognize this person from a Monto video or from the Scott Jump video. Although in the Scott Jump video, their name was the lyrics to WAP, but this is in fact the Cardi B hacker. Now, while this video is going to be showing all the different hacks that he is doing in the game, it's also going to be showing the mentality of the Cardi B hacker. It's really interesting to see how absolute power can corrupt absolutely. And this is what absolute power looks like. Real quick disclaimer, the Cardi B hacker is actually able to somehow type things in the chat using other people's names. So when you see something really offensive being said, like for example in the beginning, the SmudgeBob thing, and in the end when it's the killer and myself saying these completely offensive things, it's not us saying them, it is the Cardi B hacker, and I can show you that later on in the video. But anyways, let's get back to the content. So what's happening right now is every single time a survivor is being picked up by the killer, the Cardi B hacker will make it to where the game lags so badly that the killer can't move, making it impossible for him to hook anyone. It's extremely toxic, so I decided to give the hacker a little punishment.
Oh yeah, oh yeah, 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 yeah.
And he goes right back to doing it again. What's really frustrating about this is the fact that nothing he's doing is actually funny. It's all just extremely hostile hacking for the sole purpose of just pissing off the killer. None of it's interesting, none of it's cool, like special effects, there's no cool things happening on screen. He's just instantly healing everyone and making it to where the killer can't hook anybody. It's extremely childish, and you can see it in his attitude and the way he plays. Every chance he gets, he goes and teabags the killer, he clicks his flashlight at him, he harasses him because he knows no matter what he does, he's invincible. And the worst part is, throughout this video, I'm actively trying to get myself killed, but he won't even let me die. Because before I ever get a chance to be hooked, he will repeatedly just make the killer lag out. Really lame stuff, but I'm gonna go ahead and show you the rest of the times that he does this in a quick time lapse.
It's at this point I've had enough, and I decide it's time for me to go out of my way to make sure that this guy dies.
Yeah.
yeah, yeah. Oh yeah, 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 yeah. Oh yeah, yeah. Oh yeah, 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 yeah.
Get the fuck out of here.
And he instantly picks himself up. So this was kind of a last resort idea I had. My goal was to possibly keep him animation locked by repeatedly opening the locker, but in reality I had no chance of stopping this guy. He was above any strategies I had. To top it all off, he ends up hitting the killer with a permanent head-on stun, making it to where the head-on stun lasts for over a minute, which he could indefinitely chain if he wanted to. And then he teleports out the map right when the game ends. So once again, I'd like to start this off by reiterating that it is not us saying these things. We're not the ones saying these offensive lines, it is the Cardi B hacker. He's able to somehow manage to pretend to be us in the chat and use our names to say these offensive things. It even had me fooled for a while because I didn't even realize that was possible at the time. Go ahead and pause the video at any point to get a better look at what he says. But basically, this is what a full-blown power trip looks like. He absolutely made the game unplayable for the killer. He in the pre-game lobby and post-game lobby was saying extremely offensive things, impersonating us and saying these really offensive things. And he says multiple times in post-game chat that he just doesn't care. He brags about the fact that he has over 65 account bans since last year, and repeatedly brings up the fact that it's a waste of time if we even bother trying to ban him because he'll just make another one. And honestly, he's right. He is unironically a god and Dead by Daylight as far as the terms are considered. He can hack as much as he wants, and if he gets banned, he'll change his IP to a different country and then buy the game for the equivalent of maybe like 30 cents. That being said, it's so interesting to see how people act when they have this level of power over other people. So this video isn't a call to action to try to get the devs to ban him, because for all intents and purposes, they can't. This is more a video made in the hopes that the Cardi B hacker will see this. So Cardi B hacker, if you are watching and listening, yes, you are God. You are the God of Dead by Daylight. But could you be a more benevolent God, possibly? Instead of just ruining the game for killers and making everyone say these offensive things, maybe you could instead try to make the game more enjoyable for everyone around you. Instead of just doing these very volatile style hacks, instead try to do something more interesting and creative. Add up a bunch of special effects in, you know, a lot of explosions, a lot of different lasers falling down from the sky, something cool, something funny that'll make people that go against you laugh. It'll be interesting for you because it's an interesting new way to hack, which is something you bring up. It gets boring sometimes hacking, so you always try to hack in a different way. So in that way, it'd be interesting to see how far you could break the game, and people would actually enjoy being in games with you instead of having this situation where they don't. Look, man, I really don't hate hackers. I mean, I was a big fan of hackers back in the Dark Souls days because a lot of them would do fun, interesting things like that. But when you just ruin game after game after game and you don't care about the people that are being affected, you're just leaving a negative impact. Everywhere you go, your existence is literally leaving a negative impact on everyone around you. Look, you have the power to do anything you want in this game. Please just consider. Just consider trying to make a fun experience for everyone involved, if you're going to hack no matter what. That's all I ask. I have no ill will towards you, man, and I hope that you figure out whatever is going on in your life and you stop taking it out on everyone else.